These are the Ilan pipes, by the way. They're an Irish bagpipe evolved into this form about 250 years ago. And they have lots of reeds in them. If you know anything about reeds, they change a lot, so please excuse my tending to the tune. Well, I'm sitting here twiddling with reeds. I want to mention that probably a lot of you, or some of you, are probably aware of the fact that another iconic presence in the music scene here at Fairfield has just passed on about a day and a half ago. Dave Randall, the owner of Field of Dreams, is no longer with us. Suddenly was taken by a blood clot that went where it shouldn't have. And, been thinking about him a lot.
The reason the Irish came up with a bagpipe is because they like to sing at the same time. So they have this instrument that would, they could get some air into it and then play an instrument simultaneously.
I thought you were going to make a joke.
Yeah, me too.
There's a lot of jokes about bagpipes. And one of them is like the Irish gave the bagpipes to the Scots and they still haven't caught up with the joke. Another one is a gentleman is someone who can play the bagpipes and doesn't. Anyway, there's lots of different kinds of bagpipes, and they're from all over the world, actually. They're not just Scottish or Irish, but these are the Irish ones. They're a lot quieter than the Scottish ones. I think I'm going to do something a little unusual. Normally, I'll play a lot of dance tunes, which I will get around to, but for starters, I'm going to play a slow air, which is kind of an instrumental version of one of the old, what's called chandos, or old-style songs that would be sung in a company, maybe by a fireplace. This music was originally not designed for commercial usage, as it were, so much as just, like a lot of music, just shared amongst friends in quiet, intimate settings, like your own kitchen. My father particularly would always want me to play a slower when he always wanted me to play, period. And then he'd always want me to play slower, particularly. So I was reminded of him by Chuck's song, Ramblin' Boy. My intake valve can't cooperate. Oh, well. It's really being snippy, just a second.
You want me to tell another joke?
Yeah.
So, back in 538 AD, the Norwegians invented the toilet seat, and then about 500 years later, the Italians invented the hole in the middle.
Uh-huh. What do you call 1,000 bagpipes at the bottom of the sea?
I'm sorry? Last call, Phoebe tells me. This is not really working very well. It'll work, it's just not working well. So we'll ignore it.
Too much water.
We'll ignore it. I won't. Just get annoyed by it constantly all the time. So this is when do some more tuning, sorry. Thank you. They're changing the... Isn't this entertaining?
Yeah, it is.
All right.
Got it all on tape. On digital.
This is like Paulina tells all the performers to tune up first.
First rule of open mic, come tune.
Well, we're going to keep the bar open another 5 minutes just to help you out. Which means love of my heart, and it's an immigration song, actually. It's sung from the point of view of someone who's being left behind in Ireland by somebody who's leaving to come here. Yeah. And they're basically telling them they may have heard lots of stories of riches and rich people here, but basically they weren't going to be one of them, and that they may find that they're really... disoriented and you know, they may not like it here very much, and they should, you know, hurry back home, which is actually very rare. Once people, when they left back in the 1800s or earlier, it was pretty much understood they'd never be seen again, so they'd actually hold a wake for them the night before they left. So this is basically this song is taking place at one such occasion. And party all night and see off their loved ones at dawn to the ships.
Thank you.
few old piping jigs that played band there. The first one was called The Mist Covered Mountains, and the second one was called The Pipe on the Hob, and the third one was actually also called The Pipe on the Hob. And the pipe on the hob is not a bagpipe, it was like a smoking pipe, and the hob is like the little settling place to set things in a big open fireplace that they used to have in the old cottages where they warm themselves as well as cook everything, and basically took up the better part of a wall in your house, and it took up the better part of the house, actually. And in Ireland, it doesn't get that cold. It never gets that warm either. So fireplaces are the perfect thing. Once spent a bit of a summer in one such old-style cottage a couple friends of mine were living in. And it was a great, great feeling sitting in there playing music by the open turf fire in the middle of summer.
Thank you.
four or five of them, I guess. Four of them. I don't remember the name of the first one. Second one, I will say I got the first one from the late, great Seamus Ennis, who somebody I've been thinking a lot about in the last few days for some reason. And one of my main inspirations in piping and other things. Great folklorist as well as piper and singer and storyteller. In fact, if you're really good, I'll tell you a story, one of Seamus Ennis' stories. I hadn't thought of that until now, but I can do that if you want to stay a little late. Anyway, I got that one from him. The last three are part of a set from County Clare, where I like to spend a lot of time. The music there is particularly good. And
that's where my grandfather's from.
That's right, right. That's where my great grandmother's from.
All right.
What was I going to say? Yeah, so the Skylark Roaring Mary. Roaring Mary. It's a great image. And the last one was called The Humors of Tala. And Tala is a great place for music as well. I'm doing more tuning here just because I want to. Yes, I have any bagpipe, of course, has a bag. The reason for the bag is because it acts as a reservoir for the air, so you can keep the sound going. That's the point of a bagpipe. And the other thing is you can put more than one pipe in the bag, so you can have lots of sounds going at once. In this case, I've got four drones, and they're all in octaves of each other, except for one that's playing a fifth. Separate, and then the chanter here has a double reed in it. And these other two pipes I'm not playing because they're not really set up right now. They're having some problems, so I'm ignoring them. They'd normally be able to give you some chords by hitting these things with my wrist.
They need some water.
Some water. They need a little more than that right now. New reed. Let's see. What else to tell you? Oh, I've got this leather pad on my leg here because that enables me to stop the sound, because with a bag, I can't stop it. So most bagpipes give you a constant sound and nothing, but this one has the option of both. So I can closing the bottom here and closing my fingers. I can do that instead of just keep playing it until I stop. There you go. That's a tune I haven't thought of in a long time. And I'm going to try to play it here if I can remember it.
Thank you.
that, I don't know the name of the first one of those tunes, it just popped in my head and played that in probably 10 years. But it's a great tune, and I'm glad to have remembered it. Run for dear life a little bit, but the second one is a great old tune called Farewell to Ireland. It's a penny whistle, and if you want to learn the pipes, usually start on this thing. It's a whole lot easier, and if you can't hack this, you can forget about that. So it's kind of a weeding out level.
Still cost a penny?
No, this one is about $300, but used to cost a penny 200 years ago. Give a shout out to my friend Michael Copeland, who made this whistle, and your old friend got me into instrument making. I made this set of pipes that I'm playing here. It's because of Michael.
Great.
I think I'm going to try singing a song here. This is, does this make any sense to do? Let's see. I'm going to hold off on that. I'm going to play a tune on the whistle and then I'll sing a song after that. Maybe we'll do a story if we have time. We probably don't, but let's see. So this is one, there's another slow air called An Paschim Fionn, which means the fair-haired boy. And people tell me that I'm not a blonde anymore, but I used to be. I think of myself as being blonde still, but I don't know. Anyway, this is a great old tune. And this is from the playing of a flute player, also from Clare, a guy who's passed on quite a long time ago, but Patty Taylor. Actually, there's a Patrick Taylor in town here. It's not him. But, mm-hmm. He's still making music and well alive. This is and Paschim Fionn will play a tune after it that I composed myself called The Real Jig. I think I composed this one, it was about 15 or so, a couple of years ago.